Hey, what's up, guys? All right, you ready for this? I just made a post about this, but I realized that it's a little inundating to read this. So I wanted to explain to you guys why carbs don't make you fat. Why carbs do not make you fat. And this is like one of the main premises of my book that's coming out, Short Term Keto. It's actually coming out December 21st, you guys. So that date has been changed. If you pre-order the book, I apologize if that's any inconvenience for you. But it's December 21st is the day it will be available. It's available for pre-sale right now on Amazon, Indigo, and Barnes & Noble. So, all right, if you want all the details in it, I went ham on this in the book. And I want to explain to you why carbs do not make you fat, okay? And why actually fat can make you fat. Abso-freaking-lutely, yes, it can. And I want to share this because there is so much dogma about this in the keto world, and I'm freaking tired of it. You know why? Because I feel like half of my job as a coach is having to restore people's crazy relationship with carbs. They literally think if they put a carb in their mouth, they're going to get fat. And it's not true. And I'm explaining to you something that I think is going to help you if you're in that mindset, is going to help you get past it. Now, let me just say first, if you are insulin resistant and diabetic and have really high blood sugar, this is different for you, okay? Yeah, your blood sugar is high all the time, so this is different. So, but if you're not, if you have like normal blood sugar, this is for you if you think carbs are going to make you fat, okay? I want to talk about the middleman. The middleman between putting food in your mouth and fat storage. And carbs have a tremendous middleman, and that is your liver and your muscles. So I shared this in the post that I just posted. Your muscles, the average person can hold 350 to 500 grams of glycogen, so stored carbohydrates, in their muscles. And your liver gives you about 100 to 120 grams more of stored glycogen, stored carbs in your liver before any of that goes to body fat. Okay? So guess what fat has as a middleman? Nothing. Nothing. Whatever you don't use for building your cell membranes, your brain, making steroid sex hormones, cholesterol, whatever your body doesn't need in that moment for those kind of basic vital functions, the rest goes to body fat. You don't want to store fat in your liver. That's fatty liver. It's associated with disease. You don't want to store fat in your muscles. That's associated with metabolic disease. So whatever's extra goes to body fat. Now, if you're in a ketogenic state, this is why eating high fat works, because that is your energy source. So that fat is going straight to it's going into your liver, and it's being converted into ketones, which are then fueling your body. That's why you eat higher fat when you're keto, because you're using that fat to fuel your entire body. But if you're not in a ketogenic state, none of that fat that you're eating is getting turned into ketones. So whatever you don't use in that moment, is the rest is going to fat storage. And guess what else is interesting? It is 10 times easier for your body to store dietary fat as body fat than carbohydrates. And I'll explain what I mean by that. When you eat carbohydrates, and let's say you eat too much, and it has to be turned into body fat because you're good. Your liver is full. Your muscles are full. There's nowhere for that carbohydrate to go to be stored as glycogen, and you know, whatever you use for energy in that moment. When that extra carbohydrate gets converted into triglycerides, the stored form of fat, you burn 25 calories out of, if you eat, let me put it this way. If you eat 100 calories worth of carbs, so it's 25 grams of carbs. You eat 100 calories worth of carbs, your body will burn 25 calories just to convert those 100 calories into body fat. With dietary fat, if you eat 100 calories worth of dietary fat and it's extra and it needs to be stored as body fat, your body only burns 2.5 calories to do that. So literally 10 times easier for your body to turn extra body fat or dietary fat into body fat than carbs. Oh, you guys can't hear me? Should I put it right here? Shoot, dude, I hate when I see my lives and I'm like, oh, the sound is terrible. Hi. I'm almost home. I'm like in my neighborhood, so I think I'll be good like this. So I just want to share that with you. I want you to look at your muscles and your liver as carb sponges, right? I call them storage tanks, because they're storing it there for your body to be able to use that for energy throughout the day, for your workout, whatever. So here's the other facet of that. If you never move your butt, and you're eating carbs all day, yeah, you're going to get fat because your storage tanks are full and then you just keep eating more carbs. They got nowhere else to go. But if you get your ass in the gym and you kick it a little bit and you dump that glycogen into your bloodstream and use it, you just made room in your sponges and your storage tanks for more carbs. So you eat more carbs, it gets stored in the form of glycogen in your muscles and your liver to be used throughout the day and for your next workout. So this is why when people are like, I'm going to eat one carb and I'm going to get fat, I'm like, what? No, you guys have not been informed well if that's what you believe. That's not true. The only time that would be true is if you were super insulin resistant, had really high blood sugar, and you're also like immobile, you're just sitting there all day and you're just stuffing your face with carbs, and yeah, carbs are gonna make you fat. But guess what? So is dietary fat. You're stuffing your face with dietary fat all day and you're eating more, especially in one sitting, than your body needs in that moment. It has nowhere else to put it but body fat. You get me? You feel me? Okay, sorry, hitting a little dead zone. Anybody have any questions on this? This is one of the main things that I share in my book, Short Term Keto. And I go into way more detail on that, and I have a ton of research and evidence to support this. But this is like the part of the story that you're not being told when it comes to carbs. You don't eat a carb and it immediately goes to body fat. That is not what happens, right? It's elite athletes can store, they say, around 700 grams of glycogen in their muscles because they have more muscles. So guess what? The bigger your freaking storage tanks are, look, I made a big old storage tank right here. This can hold more carbs, more glycogen, the stored form of carbs, than if I had some like little teeny tiny bicep that was like barely nothing, right? So Charles Poliquin, he's like one of the most respected health optimization people in the world. He passed away a couple years ago, but you know, when I did his certification before he passed, he's very big on this. He would say most people don't only deserve two licks of a dried prune in terms of carbs. And what he means by that is because they're not lifting, they're not exercising, they're not moving. So they're not using the carbohydrates. They're not making room in their carb sponges. And so then when they eat extra, it goes to body fat. So at the end of the day, I think what we really need to understand is that an excess of carbs is what makes you fat, or an excess of dietary fat also makes you fat real easily. So I share this especially for the lazy keto people that like did keto, but now they just kind of eat keto-ish and they're just stuffing their faces with fat all day, but they're eating too many carbs to actually be in nutritional ketosis. And they start gaining body fat. And this is why, because your body is not turning any of that fat into ketones. And so you're just eating this huge excess and it's all going to body fat storage, and it's super, super common. Make sense? Okay, just wanted to explain that to you guys because I know like the post reading it all can be kind of boring. So I just wanted to verbalize that for you guys. Don't be afraid of carbohydrates. I say carbohydrates are less likely to make you fat than dietary fat if you are active and you have healthy blood sugar management. Way less likely. Guys, we're talking 450 bare minimum to 800 grams of glycogen stored in your liver and muscles before any of that goes to dietary fat. And then you burn 10 times more calories to convert carbohydrates into dietary fat than you do, into body fat than you do dietary fat. Hello? The dogma's gotta go, right? And this is why you have so many trainers, nutritionists that are like, they're really annoyed with keto from a athletic performance body composition standpoint. Now, I love keto. Keto does some really, really cool things. It's like a pendulum swing. If you've been like metabolically unhealthy, you're overeating, you're not exercising, you go keto, you just swung the pendulum way over here. For the first time, your body is actually learning how to run off its own fat. But just like any pendulum, eventually we want it to kind of come here, right? And so that's like the whole point of what I'm trying to teach. Keto's cool. We're not throwing that out of the bathwater. And there's some people long-term keto works well for if they're using it therapeutically or they have high inflammation or things like that. But if you're not going to be actually in ketosis and you're loading up on dietary fat, you're not going to get where you want to go in terms of fat loss. Not in my opinion. You get there way faster because here's the last thing I'll share. Carbs also help you build muscle. Can you build muscle on keto? Yes. But I dare say that the people who are building a lot of muscle on keto are eating a lot of protein and probably converting the extra protein into glucose to help with this process. So when you eat like I just trained, so I am definitely going to go eat protein and carbs. Why? I want an insulin spike. I want, insulin is a energy shuttling hormone. It's not just the fat storage hormone. I freaking hate that word for insulin. Insulin does way more than that. Insulin takes macronutrients and tells them where to go. So when we eat carbohydrates and protein after an intense workout where we just dumped a bunch of glycogen out of our sponges, and then we eat amino acids and protein with some carbs, that insulin spike from the carbs helps shuttle those amino acids into our muscles, begins the repair process, and also puts some more glycogen in there to fuel performance on our next workout. Okay? All right. That is all. Carbs do not make you fat. It's freaking BS. And I explain this all in detail in my book, Short Term Keto. So check it out if you want more of that. And if you want to go through a keto phase first, which I do recommend for most people, to get your body really good off running, off fat. You don't have to do keto to become fat adapted, by the way, but when you go into that state of ketosis, you get some other cool benefits, right? Like the anti-inflammatory benefits. And I feel like it super fat adapts you, right? Your body is so used to running off fat that it's nice to carry that with you when you start eating carbs again, because you can go really long periods of time without feeling like blood sugar hungry. Blood sugar hungry sucks. That's when your body basically doesn't know how to go into ketosis and it's freaking out and it's like, eat candy now. And when you do a phase of keto, you get rid of that, and that's cool. So if you want to do that, I'm giving away my top 100 keto recipes for free on my website when you put your order number in for the book. So my first chapter of my book is all about why keto is cool, why I still support keto, and why I still have some clients on keto, but why I don't think most people, the grand majority of people, do not need to stay there forever, and I don't think it's optimal for most people. And there's a whole bunch of other reasons why. Your adrenals, your organs, your neurotransmitters. That's another live I'll have to do, is helping you understand how nutritional ketosis impacts your mental health and your neurotransmitters. Your serotonin will go lower. Your dopamine will go higher. Your GABA will go higher. These are things you need to understand. So it's all in the book. But I'll do another live on that one because I think it's really important too. Okay. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Have a great Sunday. Bye.